with Sean Gregory this morning from Sarytogan Graphite. Sean, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to speak, Sean. An update from you this morning here on the test work underway on some samples from the Sarytogan Graphite Deposit in Kazakhstan. What's the latest?
Yeah, look, we're very eager to give our shareholders an update on progress. Our shareholders will be well aware that our flow sheet really depends on producing this bulk flotation concentrate. That's the first step in our process. And by having that bulk concentrate available, we're then able to do a bunch of test work further downstream. That work is progressing with our lab partner in Germany. And today we're announcing that we've doubled up on that effort. And we've also appointed the laboratory partner here in Perth, who had the initial success in the flotation, to double that effort on that bulk concentrate production.
You mentioned here an alternative thermal purification flow sheet. What does that involve?
Yeah, so look, before we go to the thermal, Andrew, let's just touch on the chemical flow sheet, our base case flow sheet. Now, our base case flow sheet, once we've got this bulk concentrate production, we can then send a few kilos to a whole bunch of different applications. Firstly, we'll be sending some to Pro Graphite, and they'll be doing the alkaline acid treatment, that base case chemical purification flow sheet. They previously achieved 99.87, but with that bulk concentrate and with one extra important step, we think that they can exceed the battery specification of 99.95. Now, that extra step is to remove the titanium. People probably wonder, what is that 0.13% left over that we haven't been able to digest yet? And the answer is titanium. Now, the good news is titanium is heavy, in fact, almost twice as heavy as graphite. So we can use a device for gravity separation where we spin the material around and the heavy material sinks. And we then think that that will actually be enable the upgrading via the chemical flow sheet to battery specifications. Let's roll into the thermal. So that's an alternative. And it's really important to note that this is not because we're not confident in our base case chemical flow sheet, but more so because of the studies discipline that we hold very dear to our heart, and that is at the pre-feasibility study level of detail. It's really important to consider the entire universe of options to make sure that we pick the best option going forward. So if we didn't look at thermal purification, we wouldn't be doing our duty. So there's some small samples off on the way to some international laboratories, and part of that bulk concentrate will also be reserved for thermal purification work. Now, it's an interesting pathway. It's a lot hotter temperatures. They run it at 2,000 to 3,000 degrees Celsius, but from all reports, it is extremely effective, and it typically achieves purities far in excess of battery specifications, which would be a good thing in the battery world, but it also opens up some advanced material uses that could be very interesting.
And you say the end result, achieving these battery testing results by year end, you're still on track?
Yes, it is. And that's the most important thing. Right at the end, at the end of last year, we set ourselves a timetable. We said bulk concentration quarter two, we said spheroidization quarter three, and we said battery performance test quarter four. Turns out that bulk concentrate production will drift into quarter three, but all of that other test work is lined up such that the overall schedule will be achieved.
Good to speak, Sean. Thanks very much.
My pleasure, Andrew.